All right, what's up? So today we're going to cover what's going to make you a winning sales rep versus a losing sales rep so you can always stay at the top of your game. The number one fundamental element that separates the top from the bottom as relates to performing sales reps is going to be follow-up. So what I want to cover with you today is going to be the three things that are stopping you from having effective follow-up. And that third one is going to be more so helping you understand what's really happening when you're not following up with the deals and how it's more than likely something that you've never considered before. So let's just go ahead and start running through these. So the first thing, guys, is going to be the amount of touch points that you're actually doing in order to stay in front of your prospects. So this way you can advance them through the sales cycle all the way from stranger to enrolled client. All right, so out of the gate, just understanding the different ways to do it. So you're gonna want, we'll say that an average about 7 touch points in order for you to take a complete stranger to a closed deal. I wanna share with you a few different ways that you can do that in case you're wondering, what are all the ways that I can actually stay in front of this person? So number one, a little old fashioned, but at the same time, it still works and it's not dead. That's gonna be the telephone. Actually picking up the phone and calling your leads. And I know a lot of people don't like to do it because it might seem tedious, annoying, and you might even tell yourself no one picks up the phone anymore. But the reality is nearly every single human being in the world has one of those things in their pocket. So you have to consider that for a second. Number two is going to be emails. Right? So again, maybe a little old fashioned, and a lot of people are using cold emails nowadays to acquire new clients. But as it relates to staying in front of your clients, using email is a powerful approach to be able to add a little variety in the way you're following up with your clients. Last thing that you want to do is use the exact same follow-up method every single time to try to get in front of them. Okay? Next is going to be social media. Now, this is also a common misconception, okay? So as it relates to social media, people feel that my client or my niche is not on social media. They're not on Facebook. They're not on Instagram. They're not on, you know, a LinkedIn, really whatever platform you're using, right? Clubhouse, I don't know. But the truth is there are no businesses on any of these platforms. There are only people that happen to hold a title within a business using the platform. Okay, so I want you to consider that for a second when you decide, like, is my business on social media? So what you can do, a little hack here, you can go on LinkedIn, look that person up on LinkedIn, and then highlight their name, or if they're in a specific niche or whatever, look it up on LinkedIn, highlight it, and then move that over to Facebook, and it'll actually pull up their account on Facebook more times than not, along with their job title and where they work. So this gives you another avenue, another touch point, place to reach out to them. Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, emails, phone calls, okay? So these are all different ways to get in front of somebody. Another really cool hack is to be able to, if you have their business address, right, depending on what type of line of sales that you're in, you can go on Amazon and you can actually type in their email or copy and paste their email right into the search bar, and it'll pull up their wish list. So this way you can take whatever it is that they have on their wish list, one or two of those things, and actually send it to them, okay, as a gesture. And another way is you could also text. All the ways that we have so far is you can text, phone call, email, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. All of these are phenomenal ways to stay in front of your prospects. Now, as it relates to when in the heck that you actually reach out to them using one of these methods. Now, my suggestion is if it's a brand new lead, I would stay in front of them every single day. Now, as 2 weeks goes by, I would separate that time between 3 days. As a month goes by, just put them inside of your CRM or whatever tool you're using to manage them, whether that be Salesforce, Pipedrive, Go High Level, whatever that is for you. And I would schedule it a week out. So you always stay in front of them, doing something referred to as value to the void. Value to the void is where you're actually sending them something worth looking at. You're not just saying, hey man, how are things going? Hey man, ready to hop back on a call? These are things that you know you hate seeing, and I promise you, your prospects hate seeing them too. So you want to focus on sending them something actually worth looking at, some type of information that relates to whatever their obstacle was that stopped them from getting started with you on the first call in the first place. So for example, if they were struggling with their closing percentages, I would have created a video that I maybe presented to somebody else, saved it, and said, hey man, created this new video. I know you told me before you guys are working on increasing your closing percentages. Thought of you first, and then send it to them, right? This is value into the void. So this way it gives them a reason. You're distracting their day, right? So give them a reason to look at it. So I would suggest to make sure that this is how you structure your follow-up to at least have a process behind it. If it's a new lead, every day. After 2 weeks, every 3 days. After 1 month, every week. And then moving forward, every freaking week moving forward until the prospect, as you know, either dies or blocks you. Those are gonna be your two options. So that's what we suggest with the amount of time between follow-ups. And then now you have a variation of follow-ups that you can choose from and how you get in front of them, different touch points. My suggestion is if they contact you on one platform, whether that be Facebook Messenger, text, email, whatever that is, right? Focus on using that channel until they ghost you and then use another channel. But always use the one of their primary form of communication. So let's get into the second thing. This is gonna be the really alarming statistic, honestly. The majority of closes made from stranger to complete close, about 82% of them require at least 7 follow-ups. All right, so this is from the time that either it's a brand new, a stranger, right? You've either gotten them on the first call and you're following up with them through the sales cycle, or it's completely brand new and you're just getting them on the sales call in the first place. So it's an average of a minimum of 7 touch points, okay? And we've already gone over the different ways that you can reach out to them, you know, those different variations. Another alarming stat, and you probably already know this, but really good sales reps average around 30% close rate on calls they actually connect with. So that's not no-shows that were on the calendar, people that were supposed to meet with you and didn't. These are gonna be people that actually met with you and you hopped on a sales call with. So roughly 30% of those will close. Those are really good sales reps, right? 40% if you're just an Olympic athlete, pretty much, a closer. But when you do the math, that means that you're losing 60 to 70% of your deals, even if you're the top in the industry. So I just want you to consider how much is lost rather than how much you gained whenever you choose not to follow up the leads that already showed a high level of interest in you. Super alarming stat. And a lot of time people just focus on, let me get the next opportunity, not realizing it's a lot easier to close a deal than you've already been in front of. So let's get into the third thing. Now, this is a new perspective change for you and how you can look at follow-up. And this is really overlooked and very rarely is it even viewed in this way. But when it comes to following up with your leads, I want you to think about this, okay? So when somebody brand new hops on a call with you, on sales call, and you go through the whole dog and pony show, right? You're helping reshift their mindset, you're moving them along the sales process, but they don't buy from you. And they say they wanna buy in a week or 2 weeks or a month or whatever. And they tell you they're for sure committed to you, all right? And you hear this and you wanna believe it, but you know deep down that they may not buy, but you follow up with them anyway. Now, a lot of the time, you can close this deal if you follow up properly with some of the things that we already told you in this video. But that being said, you're gonna run into one major obstacle. And that obstacle we refer to as marketing for your competition, all right? And here's what that looks like. So you've already reshifted a lot of their mindset. They've already committed that they want to buy and they're saying to you they want to buy from you. Now what ends up happening here is because you've advanced their mindset and they are committed to buying from you, what happens now is their mind is now opened. So now when they're on social media or they're driving around or whatever, they're seeing more ads for topics they normally wouldn't have seen before. Similar to how when you buy a car and all of a sudden after you bought that car, you see that same car everywhere, right? So what ends up happening now is this prospect that said they're gonna commit to you in a week, 2 weeks, 4 weeks, they're now hopping on other sales calls just to hear them out, okay? And what ends up happening is their mindset is now farther along in the sales cycle. because you've already worked them from zero to one, right? So you've gotten them from not wanting to buy at all to considering buying and committing to you in 1 to 4 weeks, whatever that looks like. So now when they just want to hear someone out on another sales call, that sales rep has it even easier than you did because they're farther along in the sales cycle. So choosing not to follow up with them is you doing all the heavy lifting and making it easier for your competition, so this way they can earn the commissions that you should have and they get to live the life that you would have. That covers this entire training. Hopefully this is incredibly helpful. Just to recap with you guys, first thing we went over here today is the 7 touch points that is required in order to do follow-up and when to do the follow-up. The second thing is the percentages of deals lost when you don't do follow-up, alarming stats. And number 3 is gonna be what happens when you don't follow up, you end up marketing for your competition. So I hope this is incredibly helpful. If it was, let us know below what your number 1 takeaway was, and we're looking forward to seeing you on the next one. Thanks for watching this video. Hopefully it was helpful. You know, I'd love to hear from you. Drop a comment below. I personally go and read all the comments. Reply as quickly as I can, and we also take those suggestions to make more videos depending on what you want to see. I also included some assets down below in the description. So regardless of where you're at in business, there's some free assets, some not free assets, depending on how quickly you want to accelerate where you're currently at to get to the next level. And I put that on here to help everyone that watches this channel. So I really appreciate you. So go check those out, and I'm looking forward to seeing you on the next video. And before I forget, subscribe to the channel. If you really like this video, you definitely want to subscribe to the channel and see the next video we have coming out. You're not going to want to miss them. And hit the bell so this way you can actually get notified. Anyway, looking forward to seeing you on the next one, and I'll be answering your comment down below.